Dina Perley here from McCurdy Real Estate in upstate New York. I cover the whole area around the Capital Region, and I love going up north because that's where I'm from, Glens Falls, New York. Anyway, I'm here today to talk to you about real estate agents and whether or not you need one. So I kind of have a joke that everything in real estate is true, and it's absolutely true. Sometimes you don't need a real estate agent. If you were buying a house from your cousin and everything's cool, you already agreed on a price and you're not getting anything fixed and that sort of thing, then you're all set. However, for most people, getting a real estate agent can be very, very important. So one cool thing about when you're a buyer is that you don't pay your real estate agent. Yay! The seller's agent actually pays the real estate agent. So that's a really, really good thing. So if you're a buyer, get yourself a real estate agent that's there for you, that will, you know, go to showings with you, that will put in offers for you, because they're free. Literally, they're free for you. They have so much knowledge. They have to. They go to school. They have to pass tests, and they have a broker that they can ask a million questions to. So if you are thinking about buying a house, please, 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 please contact a real estate agent. Zillow can even refer you to one. You can get one all kinds of places. Ask on Facebook. I guarantee if you put on Facebook, hey, I need a real estate agent, I guarantee that somebody will say, hey, you should use blah, blah, blah. And I'm hoping that they say, hey, you should use Dina Perley. She's really good. There's a lot of different places you can see reviews for real estate agents as well, especially Zillow. Zillow is a mammoth company that has a lot of information. Go on Zillow, check people's reviews. It's just like anything else. So anyway, getting back to why you need a real estate agent, there's a lot of steps, okay? It's not just you find a house, you give them the money, and everybody goes home. There's like 20, 25 people involved in any real estate transaction, especially if you're a first-time home buyer, or even if you haven't bought in, 20, 25, 30 years, it's gonna be a little different, right? So, we start out by getting you pre-approved for your mortgage, if you haven't already done that, and a lot of people haven't. Your real estate agent can refer you to a good mortgage person. They also can refer you to a lawyer, and I love to make this joke. And when you're going in for brain surgery, you want a brain surgeon doing your surgery, right? If you have a cousin that does corporate law, they're not going to be able to do a real estate transaction as well as somebody who does it every day. You don't go to a barber who only cuts hair once a month. It's one of those things that you want to get a real estate attorney. So talk to your real estate agent. Well, know several. I could name five of them right now that would do a great job for you, as long as you're in my area. So anyway, so we can refer you to mortgage people. We can refer you to attorneys. We can also refer you to people who, for example, know how to dig a septic tank and can check to make sure the one you're buying in the house is correct. We know inspectors. We know all these people. Yeah, you kind of do need a real estate agent and a real estate attorney and, people in the business. So just so you know, those are some of the things. Now, with each one of those comes other problems. You have underwriting, you have to coordinate with the other real estate person. So please use a real estate agent, especially if you're buying, because they're free. If you're selling your house, I can tell you right now that there are going to be things that are going to come up as problems when you're selling a house. It never in my entire life has gone without it. There's always something that comes up. The real estate agent is there to help you find people who can fix your, plumbing that is 100 years old and needs to be replaced before you can have it done. Some, not all real estate agents use professional photographers. I highly recommend if you're going to list your house, go check out that person's other listings to see if they seem to have done a good job of staging the home and make sure there's, good lighting and all kinds of fun stuff. You want something professional, and so you hire a professional real estate person. The real estate agent will also coordinate with all the buyers. We have a system in place, so you don't have to be there if somebody wants to see the house. We only let, licensed real estate people go to the houses. A lot of people are like, well, I'll just do it for sale by owner. And you can do that. It's absolutely fine. However, you're going to have to let people into your house all the time. You're going to have to take phone calls from other agents. You're going to have to hire your own real estate attorney and all kinds of fun stuff. So usually it's best just to hire a professional. You're not fixing your own carburetor. Why are you, you know, going to go ahead and hire yourself as a real estate agent when you've never done it before? If you have, go ahead. I'm talking to you, Cheryl. I have a friend who was in real estate a long time ago. So those are my two cents on why you need a real estate agent. And you can call me anytime. You can call me for advice if you're in California. If you're in, you know, Rhode Island, I can call and talk to you, and I absolutely will, and answer any questions and even get you a good real estate attorney and a real estate agent. So give me a call, 518-535-3525. Again, 518-535-3525.